What's up, Navigation Traders? In this video, I want to show you how to set up a butterfly spread on the TastyWorks platform. So we're looking at a chart of SPX, the S&P 500. So if you wanted to set up a butterfly spread in SPX, you would simply go to the trade tab. All the different option chains are shown, and then we want to choose the option chain with 30 to 60 days to expiration, and we want to stay in the monthlies. So that would be right here, 35 days to expiration. Simply click the dropdown. It opens up all the different strikes to choose from. Now, when we put on a butterfly, you can do it as all calls or you can do it as all puts. We tend to do our butterflies with all calls. Our back-tested studies show that they perform just a little bit better, but there's not a whole lot of difference if you do all puts or all calls. So with a butterfly spread, remember, we're going to sell the at-the-money strikes, and then we're gonna buy the wings above and below. The at-the-money strikes, you're gonna sell twice as many as you do the wings. So I'll show you what I mean. And we can do this manually by just choosing the at-the-money strikes, which in this case is $27.50, and we can simply click on the bid to sell that. Now you see that's highlighted with red, and it shows S1 over here. But we don't want just one contract, we want to do two. So you can simply click on the quantity button down here, and now you see that moves to S2. We're selling two contracts at that strike. You can also see it down below in your order, sell to open, -2, meaning we're selling two, 35 days to expiration in the appropriate cycle, and the strike is at $27.50. Okay, so that's what we call the body of our butterfly. Now we need to buy the wings. And to do that, you're simply going to go to the strikes that you want. In this case, the way that we pick the different strikes, or the way that we pick our wing width, is we look at the expected move. So in the next 35 days until these options expire, the expected move in SPX is plus or minus, call it 82 points, okay? So we want to buy our wings beyond the expected move. So let's just call it 85. So what we'll do is we just count 85 points from the at the money. So we can say 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 85. So that would be the 28.35. And then to buy that, we simply click on the ask. Now, what happens is it defaults to doing the same number of contracts. So it's showing us buy two, but remember, we want to buy half as many as what we sold at the money. So what we need to do, simply highlight that, click on quantity, and kick that down to one. You saw that change from B1 to B2, okay? So now we're selling two at the money. We're buying one of the wings 85 points away, because that's beyond the expected move. Now we need to buy another wing below the current price, okay? So we do the same thing, count 85. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 85. That'd be the 26.65. We simply click on the ask, and that populates a B1, and it's highlighted in green, showing us buying one contract. Okay, so we're selling two of the at the money, and we're buying one wing below that price and one wing above as far as price goes. So that's how it's all set up. Now, that's one way to do it. And the other way to do it, if we clear that off, just like we've shown in our other TastyWorks demo strategies, is you can use the strategy dropdown. Okay. So these toggle back and forth from long to short. When you enter a butterfly, we are buying it. We're going long a butterfly. So we want to make sure that's on long. You can toggle between put or call. We want to do call. And then from the dropdown, choose butterfly. And so then once you do that, it automatically puts that on your screen. However, it defaults to one strike out of the money. Okay. So we don't want to do that. But what you can do is then simply click and drag. So we can drag that down to the strikes that we want. And let me make sure what those strikes were again. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 85. So it'd be this one here. And then same thing here. We want to go 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 85. So we're 85 points away on either side. Those are the strikes we want. And then you can see down below that you've got your different statistics. Probability of profit, 29%. Probability of making 50% is 95%. You've got your theta, your delta, your max profit, your max loss, and everything is set to go. Now, if you like that, you understand everything you've got here, you can go ahead and shoot that into the broker to get filled. Or if you're a visual trader like myself, I like to go over to the curve tab, curve mode, make sure the analysis tab is clicked as well, and that'll bring up your visual of the butterfly, okay? So again, this is the body where we sold the two contracts, and then these are the wings where we bought one on both sides. Now, if you look at this and say, man, I'd like my butterfly to be a little bit wider, you can just click and drag these on either side if you like. Or if you want it to be a little bit more narrow, you can bring them in to have a little bit more of a narrow butterfly, okay? And so that gives you an idea of what that looks like. You can scroll your mouse and look at the little flag to say what your P&L at expiration would be. So the max risk on this side is 1,500 and, let's go ahead and lock this so they don't change. 1,565 to the downside. And on the upside, 2,065, this is a little bit unbalanced because we were moving the strikes around. And you can see at the very peak, your max profit is $4,935. Obviously, we're not gonna hold all the way to expiration, but that gives you your visual representation of the butterfly. Of course, you can pop out your window here and change the different expirations. You can change the day that we're looking at. So as we move through time, you can see your P&L line. If you can play with the volatility. Obviously, we want volatility to contract to benefit this. So you can see as volatility goes down, your profit line goes up. And so you can play with that and get an idea of how the position will perform based on price and volatility and time and all the stuff that goes into trading butterfly spreads. So I hope that was helpful, showing you how to set up a butterfly spread on TastyWorks.